The Wealthy Empire Network.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Jeremy Cash, live and direct with another valuable video for you. Today is a good day because I'm announcing that I'm going to do a $3,000 giveaway by next video. If though, this is an if y'all can go subscribe to the Pipology channel and get that account to 10,000 subs, I will do the $3,000 giveaway next video. I already got the money ready for y'all, but y'all gotta go get it to 10K subs. It's already at 5K, 5,000 more people. Just go on over there, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and it's lit. All right, but today we're gonna go over the Forex basics, what you need to know as far as your lot sizes and, you know, how to calculate them and stuff like that. And also your risk to reward ratio, risk to reward ratio. There we go. All right, so you need to know those things, you know what I'm saying, whenever you train Forex. That way you don't just screw your account up, man. Y'all be tearing your accounts to shreds, you feel me? So I'm gonna teach y'all that, so that way y'all don't gotta worry about that no more. But before we do that, make sure you like this video. Like the video, man. Make sure you hit the notification bell. Thank you guys for watching. Also, make sure you comment your Cash App, Bitcoin, Payoneer, PayPal, whatever you got below. And as I make money, I give it back to my subs as an appreciation. You feel me? So let's get into the video.
All right, we here. Let's get it. All right, so today we about to talk about lot sizes and all kind of other stuff that you need to know when you want to deal with the basics. So let me click here. This right here is what we call a micro lot. All right. This right here is what we call recess. This is for the kids. This right here is where you're playing around in the market. All right. So if you ever see this on your chart and you're confused, 0.01, you're like, what is that equivalent to? It's 10 cents in the market. All right. So this is playground. You know, this reset. This is what I call recess. All right. So 0.02 is 20 cents per pip. All right. These are per pip. 10 cents per pip. So every move is moving by 10 cents. You got that? All right. 0.03, 30 cents. 0.04, 40 cents. This is how you can calculate your lots. All right. Now, when you're brand new, this where you need to be at. Alright, you're gonna find out real soon. But this right here where you need to be at when you're brand new. You don't need to be messing around with this other stuff that I'm gonna show you here in a minute. Alright, so we go to 0.05, that's 50 cents per pip. Alright, now I know some of y'all want that fast money and you're gonna mess around and get brought to your knees because the market gonna humble you real quick. I ain't playing with you. You'll find out. Just keep on watching. This right here is what we call a mini lot section. This is right here is what I call PE. You remember in school when you had PE? You know, this when you get a little older, okay? You got PE, you in the gym, you know, you trying to finesse, you trying to do your thing in there, impress the girls and stuff like that. Impress the guys, you know how y'all do. PE right here, 10 cents. So you get that 0.10 lot size. It's a mini lot. That stands for a dollar per pip. Okay, 0.20 is $2 per pip, so on and so forth. Y'all get it, right? 0.3, well, 0.30, $3, 0.40, $4 per pip, and 0.50, $5 per pip. All right, so you got recess, PE, and then this right here is called bring me to my knees, please, because this right here ain't gonna play with you. These are the standard lots. This right here gonna humble you. You mess around. You come over here thinking you about to play around. Nah, big fella. You need you an account for this right here. You need your account size need to at least at minimum be 500 to a couple thousand, right? Some of y'all might say 500 ain't even enough, which it really ain't. But it really is. It could be. You know, I messed around on a couple standards. It's a bit risky, but these standards gonna humble you for real. Alright, so that's a dollar. You know, one standard is $10, is equivalent to $10 in the market. Two standards is equivalent to $20 in the market. Three standards is $30 per pip in the market. Four standards is $40 per pip. Five standards is $50 per pip. Now this is when y'all mess around on these and that market hit that quick jump and then move you 100 per pip and you're out of there. Your account blown because you was messing around. over here. This is what I call bring me back to church. Because after you be depressed, losing, blowing your account on this right here, you're going back to church. Oh, yeah, you can believe that. All right, so this is how you can understand the market, all right? When you do a 10 pip move, all right, when you're trying to understand on these micro lots, all right, you do 0.50. Let's say this is your lot size right here. 0.50 times 10, because you did a 10 pip move, brings you to $5. That's what you done made. You know, and some of y'all, see, y'all want to get rich so quick with that $5, y'all like, nah, that ain't enough. I'm trying to get this money. And then you're going to mess around and get brought to your knees. Playing around over here. I'm just saying, when you're brand new, you need to stay over here and then move your way up. You know, you can't just be jumping straight here, because this ain't going to play with you. I'm going to tell you that right now. All right? So, another example. A 20 pip move. All right? So, let's say you do 0.50, right? 50 cent per pip. Times 20 pips equals $10. That's how you calculate that, all right? Now we come over here. A 10 pip move over here. Let's say you did a 0.50 lot, a mini lot, 50 cent, I guess you could say, or $5 per pip. You did that, you times that by 10, you get $50. So a 10 pip move over here gets you 50 bucks, right? 20 pip move, 5 times 20, it's gonna get you 100 bucks. Now you mess around over here on the dark side, 10 pip move, 50 times 10 gonna get you 500. That's why people like this right here. You know what I'm saying? When y'all trying to mess around on these right here, you either gonna win or you gonna lose. And if you lose, you gonna lose big. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta be careful on these standards. But let's say a 20 pip move, 50 times 20, I'm getting my $50 right here, $50 times 20, $1,000. $1,000 20 pip move. That's $1,000 day. See, this the part that everybody want to be at, but you got to work your way up. So start down here and play around with your, you know, at recess, then come to PE, and then come on over here. You know what I'm saying? But hey, you ain't got to listen to your boy. But I'm telling you, you want to learn how to blow an account fast? You mess around over here on these standards and get humble. Bring it to your knees. All right, so let's get into the next segment. Now, what I'm gonna show y'all is, you know, your risk to reward ratio. Did I even say that right? Risk to reward ratio. There we go. All right. So when you're in a trade, well, when you want to get in a trade, all right, let me just place a sale. Right now, I'm not necessarily doing this because I think it's gonna sell. I'm just trying to show you something. So listen up. All right. So whenever you sell or buy, right, you want to know where to put your stop loss. So basically, if I click where I place my trade at and I drag it, y'all see that red line? That's my stop loss. That's my stop loss. This means if the market decides to go against me and it hits this, you know, this point, it's gonna take me out the trade. So I basically move it, let go of it, and I hover over it, and it tells me that I'm risking 213 pips. So I'm risking $426. Okay. And then I grab this again and I drag it the other way. And this is my take profit. You see? And I drag it to about right here. Now, if the market comes down and hit my take profit, I get money, right? I make money and it closed me out and I ain't got to be on my computer all day. Did what I like to do. Okay. All right. So when I hover over this, if it let me hover, there we go. It says my reward would be 289 pips. Okay. And so I would get $578. So I'm risking 400 to get 5. Or if you want to drag this down a little bit more, let's say you don't want to risk that much. Just want to risk a little bit. All right. Now that brings me to, I'm risking 240 to gain 500. So you got that? I'm risking $240. So I'm risking, how many pips is that? 120 pips to gain, how many pips we got? 289. Y'all got that? So that's how you do it. Whenever you in these markets, your risk to reward ratio, you always want to try to do at least a 1-3. All right? A 1-3. All right? So whenever you're doing that, you want to make sure that's what you do. All right. So if, let me see, let's say you got an account that's around $300 or $400, right? And you're trying to do a standard lot or a two standards on that amount, even if they even let you do it. But let's say that's what you was trying to do, right? Your risk would be how many pips? 120 pips. If you had a little bit of drawdown, it's gonna clear your account out. They're gonna margin call your butt and snatch you on up out of there. Come on up out of there is what they're gonna say, because your account ain't big enough. So that's why some of y'all, when y'all trading, you're like, man, I had this certain lot and they margin called your boy. That's why, because you ain't have enough money to be playing around with them standards. You got to use, you know, the correct lot sizes whenever you're trading. So you got $100 account. What you need to do is use some of them, you know, them mini lots. All right. Use a mini lot. Use a 0.05, all right, which is like 50 cent per pip, and you're good. Or you maybe even, you know, can go to the mini lot, you know, which is like, you know, the 0.10 to be safe. But you don't want to keep going higher than that, because a little bit of drawdown, if it goes against you a little bit, you're gonna blow your account. That's just what's gonna happen to you. Your account gone. You know, then you're gonna refund it and you're gonna blow it again. And you're gonna fund it again and blow it again. And that's what's gonna keep happening to you until you realize, okay, let me slow down on these big lots. Let me bring them lots down just a little bit. Alright, until you build your account up enough to hold the bigger lot sizes. But before that, you gotta know what you're doing in these markets. If you don't know what you're doing, you're gonna keep losing. And then you're gonna wanna quit. Forex ain't for me. Lies. It could be for you if you just have some self-control. It's okay to build an account small. What's wrong with us is this is such a fast way to make money that we don't want to take it slow. But guess what? You went through K through 12, right? You went in school. You went from kindergarten to the 12th grade, and you took all that time, right? So you might as well take at least a good 5-6 months and learn this skill all the way how you're supposed to. At least 2 or 3 months. It really don't take that long once you get it. At least take that amount of time and learn what you're supposed to learn. And once you do that, that's it. But that's how you set your stop loss, y'all. And you can do it on your phone the same way. All right. So your risk to reward ratio needs to be at least like 1 to 3. You do that and I think you're good. I think you're ready to trade. So, yeah, that's pretty much it, y'all. Y'all make sure y'all comment below. And holler at your boy, Peter.